Hello everyone and welcome back to another Infinite Galaxy video. Just a popping up message, there will be another downtime, but I will try to finish the video before. So we just got the big update and a lot of stuff changed. The crew members got their skills reduced dramatically, all the flagships got resetted, and just before the update I was nearly finished preparing a video about modules. So I will give you a quick overview what happened with the modules and anyhow what I have so far. Nearly all modules, beside one that I found, had attributes or the stats also reduced, adjusted in a lower kind of way. Let's say it like this. I don't want to say nerfed because probably it's just trying to get everything work well together. A huge change is for the fleet effect. These were cut into around half, sometimes even more, but also the damage, so like the attack, has been reduced. For the protection module, it's the same thing. It's not fleets for the protection modules, it's always only for the warships. The percentage got reduced and nearly all the values got reduced here too. There are only two modules I saw so far that have a little bit better value now. This also goes very important together with the change here in our crew power. Where before the tech bonus gave you 40% kinetic attack bonus, it's now lower. So I don't even have the full tech bonus anymore. Before I was at 120 tech or something like this. I got 40% there. I think now the limit is probably somewhere at 10%, 20% or even 18%. We will see. So as all our modules got resetted, all our flagships got resetted, this is a great timing to release this video, and I hope it might help you a little bit. I did now update all my data already, and I updated the bonus from the flagship, from the crew. I do have additional kinetic, and I also have one crew member that increases the laser weapons. So I come up then with these bonies. I will for now put all these bonies to zero. And let's just look for the beginning only at tier 1, so the green weapons in level 1. The attack cooldown, and then I calculate based on this the DPS. As you see, without any bonus, they are pretty close to each other. Missiles have a bonus damage to the shields of the enemy, while laser has a bonus damage to ignore armor. So armor does not work with shields. Damage you do to shields is not getting reduced by armor, only damage you do directly to the HP is reduced by armor. The kinetic weapons, for me, they are looking the most promising still now, because I do still get the 10% or later even more bonus on kinetic weapons. I do also get some bonus on the laser weapons, but I won't put this inside. Missile, we do have for our flagship, if you use Hercules, you got 3.5% missile bonus. Before, this was 7.5. So if you put this in, you will see now kinetic weapons, based on this, is getting higher, and also missile getting higher. Till you get a good laser bonus will take some time. So I did upgrade kinetic weapons, and I want to show you what happens there. So I will for right now, just take a look at Kinetic. For all the modules, it is the same. If we look at level 1, it is clear that the highest tier does the highest damage, so that's not really surprising. But I then started to level up tier 2 and tier 3, so I will right now only look at tier 2 and tier 3. I don't have enough materials to level up my tier 4 completely. So what I want to show now is what level difference do you need to make it more valuable for you to use lower tier or higher tier? And this is very interesting. If you look here at tier 2 and 3, level 5, I was able to upgrade my tier 3 to level 5, which gives me a DPS of 399. At the moment, this is the highest I can get. I don't have enough blueprints to go to level 6 or level 7. As you can see, the damage, no matter if we include the fleet effect or not, the damage of the blue one, so tier 3 is purple, tier 2 is blue, level 6 is lower than a level 5 purple one. Only if you get two levels higher, it makes sense, or is it two levels difference is a point where you will get higher damage. So that also means if you have to choose between using a green common weapon or a blue uncommon weapon, if you can upgrade the uncommon weapon to level 5 and you can upgrade the common weapon to level 7, the common one will give you higher damage. If you can upgrade an uncommon one to level 3 and or what do we have here? We have the uncommon one. Let's take this one. If you look at this, if you can get the purple one to level 3, let's make it purple. So, and now you look at here, the level 5, its damage is already higher. So one tier level has the same effect as two upgrade levels. This was very important for me because probably you have the same problem. At one point, I just run out of blueprints, and when this happens, I have to decide what am I going to do. You can see here I got a level 5 kinetic purple weapon, and I was able to upgrade my blue weapons to level 7. It makes most sense for me. I had enough blueprints for the purple ones, but at the module you can also see I was not able to get another blue module to level 7, so then I had to get a level 7 green one inside, because I was only able to get to level 3 from the available blueprints. I could only get to level 3 of the blue modules, so already a level 5 green module was giving me more bonus there. Well, the server just went down. Probably as soon as I click somewhere, I will fly out of the game. Just wanted to share this with you, as probably a lot of you, like me, now will have to redo your modules. One tier level has the same advantage as two upgrade levels. Keep this in mind. Take a look. How far can you upgrade? How many blueprints do you have? Blueprints are for me the resource that is limiting my upgrade effort. So it's very easy to see how high you can upgrade based on the number of available blueprints you have. And then you can say, or you can decide at what point it makes more sense for you to go to a lower tier, because this is where you can reach a higher level. Okay, hope you liked the video. Hope it will help you a little bit. And leave me a comment in the comment section if you found something else out. Please give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hope to see you next time. Bye bye.